We are going to be blessed. Hallelujah. Amen. So Mike, I am preacher and I am interpreter. I know they are ready. Amen. Thank you so much. May God bless you. Every no mikono miwili. Every say, my Lord, speak to me. Minister to me. I am waiting to receive from you. Are you waiting to receive from the Lord? How many are ready? Hallelujah. Amen. Let's lift our hands. Let's lift our hand. With a lot of joy, we have a wonderful servant of God, a man who has crossed many countries preaching the word all the way from New York, USA, and God has brought him to our country to bless us. Amen. Let's clap to Jesus as welcome here. Amen. Thank you so much. Together with this interpreter, Pastor James Ooko. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. May God bless you. Makovi yako isipunguke. Makovi yako isiishe. Mpaka mgeni afike. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Amen. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Makovi. Ongeza Makovi. Amen. 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 Thank you. Dr. Thomas Paul. Welcome. May God bless you. Welcome. May God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Thank you so much. Together with this interpreter. Amen. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Can we lift our hands to Jesus? How many know he's the boss? How many know Jesus is the boss? How many know he's not only great, but he's also God? So before we do anything else, we want to lift our hands and honor him. We give honor to great people, but first let's give it to him because he's the reason for everything. He's the reason for our life.
Tunawatambua watu wakubwa, lakini kwanza tumpe Yesu sifa maana yeye ndio sababu ya maisha yetu.
There's nothing good we have that he did not give us.
Hakuna lolote lizuri tulilo nalo ambalo yeye hakutupa.
Anything bad,
chochote kibaya,
came from the devil and his ugly friends.
Inatoka kwa shetani na marafiki zake wanaochukiza.
But we destroy all them again in the name of Jesus right now.
Tunaziharibu sasa kwa jina la Yesu.
God is for us.
Mungu yuko pande yetu.
So they cannot stand against us.
Hawezi wakatuzuilia.
I prophesy in the opening prayer that enemies will fall to the ground and not get up again.
Ninatabiri juu yako adui zako wakaanguke na wasisimame.
I prophesy in the opening prayer that enemies of ours will fall and be crushed to nothing. I prophesy in the opening prayer that God is going to vindicate us from all evil and evildoers. I declare that no weapon formed against us can ever succeed against us. We are smart and the devil is stupid.
Sisi tunaendelea na shetani ni mjinga.
We are on top and the devil's friends are down.
Sisi tuko juu na shetani ako chini.
God has highly exalted him.
Mungu amemuinua yeye zaidi.
And given the Lord Jesus Christ the name above every other name.
Na amempa jina lililo juu ya majina yote.
Therefore, when we're with him, we're on top too.
Tukiwa naye pia tuko juu.
Somebody shout yes.
Mtu aseme ndio.
Shall I receive?
Sema nimepokea.
Can you feel the anointing? The anointing is falling.
Je, unahisi upako?
The anointing is falling here right
upako
now.
Unatembea mala hapa.
Shandalahasi.
Rakata la mazaya.
Just pray in the Holy Ghost for a
minute. Nena kwa ndimi kwa muda kidogo.
Pray in the Spirit. Just lift your hands up for a minute.
Nyosha mkono wako juu nene kwa ndimi kwa dakika moja.
I'll have you to sit down in a minute, but right now let's pray. We're praying. We're praying.
Sasa tunaomba kwa ndimi.
We're
praying. Jehovah, we give you glory, Jehovah. Rakata la mazaya, la la mazaya. Rando lobo kayata la 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 mazende.
The psalmist said,
Zaburi anasema,
I'll open the doors and the King of Glory will come in.
Nitafungua milango na mfalme mkuu aingie ndani.
And who is this King of Glory?
Na huyu mfalme wa utukufu ni nani?
He's the Lord, mighty in battle.
Yeye ni Mungu mkuu wa vita.
He has conquered death, hell, and the grave.
Ameshinda kifo na mauti.
So the psalmist said further in the 27th psalm.
Anasema kwa Zaburi 27.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I be afraid?
Bwana ni nuru yangu, nani nitakaye mwogopa?
Whom shall I fear?
Nitamwogopa nani?
No one. Everybody that raises their hand against us will be broken in Jesus' name. Every hand that comes against our life will be broken in Jesus' name. And I prophesy over God's people, over myself, over our bishop and his wife, and over all the people throughout the world, across the entire globe, and we're live on television, I prophesy across the world that everybody that's been done wrong by evildoers, the earth is going to pay them back. And what the thief has stolen will be returned seven times. What was stolen will be brought back. And it will be multiplied to us. The scripture says you'll have double for your trouble. The scripture says the elders that rule well should be counted worthy of double honor. There'll be no limit to what God is going to give us in this day. I declare by the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus that people around the world are going to send us resources. People that have the resources, they're going to be shaken even in their sleep. And our name will be written in the spirit to them. And they will give us every good thing that we need and want. In God's purpose, there's no lack, there's no loss. Weeping endured for a night, but joy is now coming in the morning. The attack came through evildoers. But I declare that every one of them will be judged by God. This is the day when God is stretching out his rod of blessing to the righteous. But on the other hand, he has a sword of judgment for the wicked. 10 chapters later,
from
Psalm 24, then Psalm 27. Then in Psalm 37, God told the psalmist, don't fret yourself because of evildoers. For they will soon be cut down. They look like they're doing well, but their end is not good. But he said, the righteous shall flourish like the palm tree, shall grow like the cedar tree, and the box tree, and the palm tree, and the pine tree, and the cypress tree. But God said, I will not let the wicked have free course over your life. Lift your hands. The power of God is going to begin to cause people to flourish in these days. The grace and the favor of God is going to cause people to prosper in these days like they never did before. You might have had $1 million in your life before, and I have. I said, you may have had $1 million in your life, in your possession, and
I have myself.
But
now is the day we're going to have 10 million and 20 million and 50 million and 100 million. Because the latter house will be greater than the former house. Haggai 2 said, the silver and the gold is mine, says the Lord. And I will share it with my own elect people. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says there's no limit to what I can give you if you walk with me. And the goal and the dream and the mission is not to attain things, but to perform the will of God. To do what He's ordained. The things in the world are assistance to us. They're not our goal. We don't care. Because you can have a lot of possessions that I know and be out of the will of God. Not in the perfect place where God's ordained. And though you have great possessions, you're still miserable. Why do people in the world on top commit suicide? When the world says they had everything. But in their soul was darkness. In Isaiah chapter 2, yeah Lord.
Isaiah 2.
I hear you. Isaiah chapter 2.
Isaiah 2.
The Lord said, there's no limit to the horses and the chariots and the treasures in the land. He said, if you look up and go to build up on the mountain, and you make Zion your habitation, there's no limit to the resources. But then the next verse says, but there are idols in the land. In 1 Kings 15, we see the king Asa came on the scene. And the first thing he did was remove the idolatry from the high places. And we thank God in the nation of Kenya, regardless of many issues and problems, the man and woman and the second man and woman at the top lift their hands to Jesus and have publicly said, Jesus is Lord. Can I tell you that carries power for the people? So the Lord says, and I prophesy as His servant, don't despair about what you've seen, because greater things are coming. The people that lift their hands to me and ask for my help, I will help them, even your president. So pray for him. You want to see greater things in your nation? You pray. Don't criticize, pray. Don't find fault. Talk what you want. Are you listening to God's servant here? Lift your hands. Let's decree right now, blessing over the state house. Blessing over the government. The power of the Holy Ghost upon the government men and women. And let every demon in the government come out in this day in Jesus' name. Let every wicked, corrupt fool be cut out of place in Jesus' name. Like the cancer, let them be cut out of the body of the government. I prophesy you're touching the government. You're raining fire down on the House of Parliament. You're raining fire, Lord, down on the government ministers. I had lunch with the
government spokesman a few weeks ago. He loves Jesus. He's a man of God. Isaac Mora, he loves God. And he's a very brilliant man. There are others. Lift your hands. And some that are very corrupt, they will lose the next election. I tell you right now. They will be disgraced and put out of place. And those that are going to stand in the government offices, I give it as a law by the Holy Ghost as God's prophet to the nations. They will serve God or get out. I prophesy over the judiciary. Now, very tragically, over the military. That God, those that you don't want in place, they're going to go. And it wasn't the current thing that happened. That was a good man. Real tragedy. And the pilot of the helicopter was my family friend. Magondu.
Magondu.
The pilot. Young man, he's dead today. They buried him yesterday. The family is broken and shattered. I couldn't go to the funeral. I don't think I could handle it. I just had to stay back and pray. These kind of things should not happen anymore in your nation. Lift your hands. These kind of things should not happen anymore. I speak as God's servant and I put a stop to it. And those behind these kind of events, they will be exposed. And they will not survive the consequent and judgment of God. Lift your hands. I'm speaking as God's prophet.
Right
I pray over East Africa. I pray over the East African community. That everybody that's not right in positions, they will be displaced. And the fire of heaven is opening up to pour down blessing and fire upon East Africa. All the East African nations are going to be blessed.
Inchi zote za Afrika Mashariki zitabarikiwa.
Oh yes, Tanzania.
Tanzania.
Uganda.
Ethiopia.
If the Congo has come in, then the Congo.
Ata Congo pia.
Even Zambia. I keep seeing Zambia. Zambia should be brought in.
Zambia pia inafaa ingie ndani.
All the people across the nations. What? I may be leaving some names out, but the nations of East Africa.
Mataifa yote Afrika.
And especially beloved Kenya is being blessed by God. I prophesy the economy is coming back. The tourism is coming back. The hotel industry is rising. Industries for my people. And the Lord says, watch the enemy. Even the enemy of your state. There are infiltrators that want to take over your land. Do you not know it? The Lord says, I will stop it. Because I want my people of the soil to be blessed. I see the fire of the anointing going to touch the houses of many Kenyan people. To begin to get angry at what's happening and begin to pray and declare and to prophesy even from their own houses. Even other pastors, I speak as a leader here, to other churches, other pastors, other leaders, that they'll begin to cry from their pulpits and speak against the darkness and prophesy and cancel it out. For the Lord says, I'm not going to let this happen in your land. That's my position, says the Lord. Now you as my people have to say your position. Is it mine? I want to prophesy that the industries of business are not for the heathens. The industries are not for these other people. You know the ones from other countries that come here. I can name the names. You know the ones. It's not for them. What about my own people? And the problem has been in the church, there's a lack of unity. Nobody trusts each other. Everybody's about their own game. God says, this is not pleasing to me. Where there's unity, I command blessing. I said further in the psalm. In Psalm 133. You see, we're taking a journey through the psalms as we're prophesying. The word of God is always the paramount thing. Any prophet that's not using this book is not a good prophet. Any preacher that doesn't have a handle on this word is not a good
one.
This is my word, says the Lord. And this is the guide to life. Let's keep praying. Come on, keep praying for a minute before we take our seats. Keep praying. Psalm 133 said, where there's unity, I command my blessing there. But many places there's no unity. It seems like a hard thing, even in my own mind. I speak as Thomas now. Even in my own mind, it seems like a hard thing. But I declare by the Holy Ghost a new prophecy right here, right now, from this great platform of my friend Bishop Dr. Ken and his lovely wife,
Bishop Ken, na mke wake,
Psalmist Mercy Ken.
Mercy Ken.
And all of you good people here, lift your hands up to God. I prophesy.
There's
a new move of unity coming in the church. And this is the only way things will develop. United we stand, divided we fall. The devil wants to cause division. And some things that we thought were the flesh or the works of an evil man, but really when I look at it now in the spirit, my eyes are opening right now more as I'm standing here on the platform. It's the devil that's been doing this. It's wicked spirits in high places. It's principalities and powers. It's rulers of darkness in the world that have caused division. And I speak as God's servant in the name of Jesus. I curse the works of the devil right now in Jesus' name. And the church is going to come together, get united. Jesus said, by this you know that they're my disciples, that you love one another, and that you continue in my word. And if you continue in my word, then you are my disciples indeed. John 8:31 and John 8:32, the next verse said, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. Somebody shout to Jesus right now and give him a shout. Give God a shout right now. Hallelujah. This division. And I say, Lord, let me prophesy. This rain is too much in Kenya now. I don't know why. It's kind of a sign in a way, but it's too much. I declare from today the rain will cease. I speak as God's prophet. Let this rain get normalized.
Wacha imvua ikawe ya kawaida.
And begin to diminish. It's too much.
Na ianze kupungua.
When it's flooding our people, it's too much.
Inapovurika watu wetu wateseke ni zaidi.
We're happy for the rain, Lord.
Na bwana tunaomba ni Mungu wa
mvua. Because there were years of drought in Kenya.
Maana palikuwa na miaka ya ukavu nchi Kenya.
But even in Tanzania, it's flooding.
Hata Tanzania pale.
It's too much.
Imezidi.
We command it to cease.
Wacha ipungue sasa.
Now the season of the natural is it has to rain a bit.
Ya kwamba hali ya kawaida mvua ya kawaida.
But not too much.
Lakini sio zaidi.
From today the weather will shift and change.
Kwa leo hali ya anga itabadilika.
Somebody give the Lord a hand clap if you believe God's prophet.
Yesu makofi.
2 Chronicles 20:20 said, believe his prophet, so shall you prosper.
Mambo ya nyakati 20 chini sema amini wa mtumishi wa Mungu.
Take your seats.
Neza pata kuketi.
God bless you. I love you.
Bwana awabariki na wapenda.
Oh, this rain.
Mvua.
Now, the Bible says in Ezra 6:14.
Biblia inasema kwa kitabu cha Ezra 6:14
that they built and prospered by the prophesying of the prophet.
Ya kwamba waliendelea na wakanawiri kwa sababu ya mitume.
Amos 3:7 said,
Amos 3:7 inasema,
surely I the Lord will do nothing unless I first reveal my secret to my servant the prophet.
Inasema sitafanya lolote ila kwanza nimfunulie mtumishi wangu.
Peter said,
Petero naye akasema,
in the 20th verse of one of the chapters, I think it's 120, 2 Peter 120.
Kitabu cha Petero wa kwanza 1:20.
He said, prophecy came not by the will of man, or by the impulse of man, or by the thought of man.
Unabii haikutokana na mawazo na fikira na uwezo wa mwanadamu.
But he said prophecy comes
unabii uja
through holy men of God.
Kupitia watu ambao ni watakatifu wa Mungu.
As they speak by the Holy Ghost.
Wanaponena kupitia kwa Roho Mtakatifu.
How many believe what I said about the government?
Wangapi wanaamini yale nimesema kuhusu
fedha? How many believe what I said about the economy?
Wangapi wanaamini kile nimesema?
How many believe what I said about Kenya and East Africa?
Wangapi wanaamini kile nimesema?
How many believe what I just said about the weather? And I want to, how many believe what I said about industries need to be in the hands of God's people, not just everybody else? Lift your hands and say, we receive it, Jesus. We receive it, my Lord. As according to your word, so be it unto me. While many people are living in poverty,
watu wengi wanaishi kwa umasikini,
there are even people
panaye pia watu,
that don't believe in the God you believe in,
ambaye hawamwamini yule Mungu na mwamini,
and they're making millions and billions every day.
Na wanafanya mamilioni na bilioni ya pesa kila siku.
How many know that's of the devil?
Wangapi wanajua hiyo ni shetani?
Now, if you don't understand me, do you understand him? Say it again, because they're not saying nothing. How many believe people prospering that are evil, it's not good? How many know God said here in this book that he wants to prosper us? Psalm 35:27. The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
God said, I take pleasure in the prosperity of my servant.
Inasema, Mungu anafurahishwa na kufanikiwa kwa watumishi wake.
Now the servant is the leader,
ya kwamba ni kiongozi,
but it's also the servant, no matter who you are.
Ni kiongozi, ni mtu yote yule ambaye amemwamini Yesu.
How many are serving God?
Wangapi wanamtumikia Mungu?
How many are serving God from the front to the back?
Wangapi watumikia Mungu kuanzia mbele kwenda nyuma?
How many believe you're serving God?
Wangapi wanaamini wanamtumikia Mungu?
Then God says, as you prosper, I will be happy.
Mungu anasema unaponawiri nami nitafurahi.
How many know God is God whether we're blessed or not?
How many know if we praise him or not, he's still God? Do you know that no matter what we do, he's still God? Whether people serve and obey or refuse and rebel, he's still God. But Isaiah 1:19 says something very powerful. In fact, let's start at the 18th verse. Isaiah chapter 1. He said, come, let us reason together. What that means is you have a conference with God. I want to do you a favor. I have the authority to do this. As his prophet. I schedule a special meeting between you and God. Did you hear that?
Yani mtumishi anasema anaitisha mkutano speciali kati yako wewe na Mungu.
If I was sitting out there, I'd be jumping up and down right now. Somebody lift your hands and say, thank you very much. My God, you don't believe it. See, that's the problem. You don't believe it. How many believe it? Believe his prophet, so shall you. Believe his prophet, so shall you. Prosper. Lift your hands and say, Lord, I'm waiting for the appointment. In the first service, if you weren't here, watch it online. On the YouTube channel. The Lord said that there's a visitation and consecration coming to people of this church, and I want to release it to the whole world.
Kuna kutembelewa na kutengwa ambayo inakuja kwa hii kanisa.
I mean the same kind of thing. The Holy Spirit's going to visit you.
Mungu anasema atakutembelea.
So you know exactly what his calling is upon your life. How many would like to know that? How many would like to know that?
Wangapi wangependa kujua hiyo?
I mean, you'll know what your gift is so clearly. And you'll stop wasting time. Because time is so precious. I never met a rich man who didn't respect time. And I never met a poor man who respected time enough. That's why Jesus said three things to us in his word. He said, occupy until I come. The word occupy from the Greek means to do business. And then he said, redeem the time for the days are evil.
And
then he said, work while it is day. Because the night is coming where no man can work anymore. Lift your hand and say, Lord, help me. I'll give you another one. Matthew 25, the parable of the 10 virgins. Five were wise and five were foolish.
Watano walikuwa wa hekima na watano wao wakawa wapumbavu.
Five were filling themselves with the glory.
Watano wao walijijaza na utukufu.
Making sure their lamps were filled with oil.
Wakajamanisha wakangojea wakataka hakikisha ya kwamba meta zao zimejaa mafuta.
Which is symbolic of the anointing.
Ambayo inasimamia upako.
Lift your hands and say, Lord, I really want your anointing.
Sema Bwana nahitaji upako wako.
I really want you, Holy Spirit. But five were foolish. They were just going around like nothing meant anything. The time didn't matter. But the day came when there was a doorway that got closed on them.
And they cried and said, oh, give us more time. And the keeper of the door said, no, no more time. You only have the time of your life to do everything for God. And when that time gets near or it ends, it's over.
You're finished.
I don't know about you, but I don't want to live regret in eternity. I want to be happy. I want to hear, well done, my good and faithful servant. How about you? Does anybody want to hear that? We quote that scripture thinking it's automatic. Are you crazy? Do you know there's conditions for that? When Jesus says, well done, it means well done. You're getting it? Basically, it means well did. You did well. It means you did things. If it's going to be well, not just okay. Not just sour, no, you know, like whatever. Meaning like really good, exceptional, excellent, brilliant, powerful, on top.
And
that means you did a lot. I didn't sleep much last night. And I tell the devil and everybody else, I don't even care. If you want to be powerful in this world, Bishop,
and Mama,
you have to give yourself a new middle name. Now we have our names. So you put your first name with your husband's name and made it your name. I really love that. When I first heard that at Archbishop's Church, Dr. Edward introduced you to sing. And I didn't know you. I haven't met you yet. But I met your husband up in the boardroom.
And
Archbishop walked in and stood me up in front of everybody. And when Dr. Ken was there, he said, you need to have this great prophet come to your church. So Bishop Ken did something very smart. He said, yes, sir. We'll do it. When the boss speaks, that's how it works.
Amen.
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 And that's great favor. I'm so honored. That the Archbishop counts to be worthy of so much of his favor. Archbishop Harrison Nanga, if you're watching this, and I hope you get to see this, I
want
to say that I really love you. And I really celebrate your maturity, your character, and something else, your work schedule. I want to be like you. I talk to the Lord. You speak somewhere every day. You bless multitudes and go to the next event. Hour by hour by hour, I've watched that. And can I tell you, since we got connected some months back, I'm actually doing that more myself. Lift your hands. You have to watch who you follow. Now the great man of God, Archbishop Dr. Harrison Nanga, was here 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, whatever it was. And he released a blessing on the people, so you're receiving from it. But don't let it just go by you and you don't do anything with it. Lift your hands and say, whatever came my way, I'm taking it by force. I'm taking it into myself. In Jesus' name, say it, in Jesus' name. We think preachers come and the blessing just comes. It's like, okay, that's church.
Hallelujah.
The devil is a liar.
Shetani ni muongo.
Shetani is Sendwave.
Shetani ya Sendwave kabisa.
The biggest jinga that ever was is the devil Satan.
Shetani yeye ameshindwa.
Majinga. Shaitani. Is that his name?
Yes.
Whatever his name is. Lord of the flies. Beelzebub. Whatever. Whatever he is. People said it's in the Bible. They'll look at him later and say, are you the one who deceived and destroyed the nations? You. They'll see him. I ask God for something. Before he kicks that fool into the lake of fire, I want to see him myself. I have to be careful how I do this because I have suede shoes on. If I swing my foot, my shoe might hit you. If I had tighter shoes, I would do it, but let me not do it. I
want to
kick that fool myself. Before God throws him in. Lift your hands. Who is this devil? People will say, you? He was the most beautiful. But he became the most ugly. By the curse of God. I want to tell you something prophetic. A really good principle to think about. If the devil is after you, don't worry. Even when he was after Jesus in the wilderness, he couldn't stay for long. Jesus didn't have conversations with him. He just said, it is written. And the devil had to say, I know. And he left. But if God is your enemy, there's no escape.
Amna njia ya kuepuka.
Even David said, where can I go to escape from you, Lord? If I go into the cave, you'll find me there. If I go into the sea, you'll find me there. How many know Jonah had a mission? And the big fish found him and brought him to Nineveh. So when God is after you, it's a blessing. And if the Lord has, you know, removed his hand from you because of your foolishness, you're in a very bad place. I would say repent with everything you can. Take all your money and sow it as seed into an anointed servant of God. Cry and fall down on your face and pray. Lift your hands. That's what David said. In Psalm 51:10. Are you glad I know the word? I said, are you glad that I know the word? I can do this till tomorrow and not stop. I can do this till next week and not stop. I have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of principles and scriptures in memory in my spirit. Let me be an example to you. Study the word and memorize it. Lift your hands and say, yes, I will. In Psalm 51:10, the psalmist said, you see my notes, my books are all closed. You see,
so I'm not reading.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew in me a right spirit. And then he said something awesome. He said, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Lift your hands. Sometimes when the Holy Spirit is leaving you, you're not so aware.
Wakati mwingine wakati roho wa Mungu anakuacha ama anaondoka, hauwezi ukajua.
You just get a little colder by the day.
Wewe unaanza kuingiwa na baridi pole 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 pole.
Maybe some sin has overtaken you.
Pengine kuna dhambi ambayo imekuzidi.
I want to speak to you here in this great church.
Nataka nikunenee sasa kwa hili kanisa
linalopendeza. I want to speak to you around the world.
Nataka kunenea ulimwengu wote.
To repent today.
Tubu leo.
Let's do what we did in the first service quickly right now. The scripture for this is John 1, 1 John 1 and 9.
Kitabu cha Yohana wa kwanza moja tisa.
He said, I'll confess my sin to you.
Inasema nitayakiri na nitaungama dhambi zangu.
Amen. Say with me, Lord.
Sema Bwana.
I confess my sin to you.
Nakiri dhambi zangu kwako.
Say it. Lord, I confess my sin to you. Whatever I did that was wrong. And whatever I didn't do that I was supposed to do. Say it yourself right now.
Wewe sema. Sema kile ambacho mhubiri anasema.
Say it yourself. I want to hear the voices. I want to hear your voice.
Anataka kusikia sauti yako ukisema.
I want to hear some voices right now.
Nataka kusikia sauti wa kila moja.
Lord, forgive me.
Bwana nisamehe.
Did you understand the instruction?
Je, ulielewa maagizo?
Now make the note of this. 1 John 1:9.
Tunaangalia kitabu cha Yohana wa kwanza moja tisa.
I confess my sin to you.
Nayaungama dhambi zangu kwako.
Now please, Lord.
Sasa
forgive me.
Nisamehe.
I can feel some people you're not saying it because you're stubborn.
Kuna wengine wapa kati yenu hamsemi maana nyinyi ni wasumbufu.
God will leave you for another season.
Bwana ataacha kwa wakati mwingine.
Until your heart can be broken to follow him.
Hadi wakati moyo wako utavunjika umfuate.
I feel maybe it's only half the crowd that will really catch this.
Ni nusu ya watu walio hapa wanashika lile nasema.
I'm okay with that because I know what it is.
Mimi naelewa hiyo maana nafahamu.
Let the ones that are hungry for God catch this right
now.
If you're serious, you'll talk to the Lord right now.
And say,
now listen here. I'm sorry.
Isaiah.
You don't want to do it. I can feel it in the spirit. Some people
are like, oh. I can feel it in the spirit.
When we receive Jesus,
tunapompokea Yesu,
by being what we call born again,
na kwa hiyo tunapata kuzaliwa mara ya pili,
we receive his grace and his nature.
Tunapata neema yake na umbo wake.
But never forget this.
Lakini usiwahi sahau hili.
In our life,
kwa maisha yetu,
we have to make right decisions.
Lazima tufanye maamuzi yaliyo sawa.
I do, you do.
Mimi nafanya na wewe pia ufanye.
Whether you like it or not, that's reality. Lift your hands, say reality, reality, find me, wake me up, Lord Jesus. Don't leave me behind. Years ago in my ministry, many years ago, I never said this. I didn't say it. But like the last 2 years, it's been very strong in me. I
want
to teach you something here. We need to always be repenting. And repent means to change. It doesn't just mean to say I'm sorry. It means to amend our ways and to change for the better. And many people, as I said in the first service, are walking around with so much sin in their files, so much corruption in their system, and because time has gone by, and lightning didn't strike them. They seem to look around and say, well, everything seems to be okay. But the Lord says, you've resisted me.
Lakini Mungu anasema umenikataa.
And my hand has slowly moved away from you.
Na mkono wangu pole pole umeondoka juu yako.
Revival, the name of this place even.
Uvuvio ambaye ni jina ya maana hapa pia.
This is really good.
Ni nzuri.
Revival means to give life again.
Uvuvio inamaanisha kupea uzima tena.
Meaning you had the touch, but you need to get it back again.
Inaonekana ulikuwa nalo ukalipoteza, inafaa irejeshwe tena.
I prophesy.
Ninatabiri.
That revival's coming.
Na kwamba uvuvio unaja.
But not just out in the air, but inside of me.
Sio tu kwa hewa, lakini bali ni ndani yako wewe.
Inside of my life.
Ndani ya maisha yangu binafsi.
Inside of my habitation.
Ndani ya moyo wangu.
I had a message to preach. I didn't get to it. I will not get to it. The Holy Ghost has taken over.
Nilikuwa na neno la kuhubiri la Roho Mtakatifu amechukua mashukrani.
I had a very good message. I'll preach to you in another session.
Nitahubiria wakati mwingine nijapo.
But I can't do it. Lift your hands.
Nyosha mkono wako.
The Holy Ghost is talking here.
Roho Mtakatifu ananena hapa.
God can slowly remove his hand from you.
Mungu alitoa mkono wake juu yako pole pole.
And because there wasn't something dramatic about it.
Hakukuwa na kitu ya ghafla kwa maisha.
Like the next day you saw angels.
Kama siku nyingine ukaona malaika.
Or you saw demons around everywhere.
Ukaona mapepo yamezingira.
And you got very afraid.
Na ukaogopa.
And you said, God, how help me please, sorry.
Kama Mungu, Mungu kwa nini?
Because that didn't happen.
Maana hilo halikutendeka.
You think everything's okay.
Unadhania yote iko sawa?
But yet you failed to become.
Lakini wewe ulikosa kufanyika.
What Jesus has ordained you to be.
Kile ambacho Mungu alikuumba uwe.
I'm prophesying.
Natoa unabii.
I said I'm prophesying.
Nasema na natabiri.
Yeah, nabii, right? Nabii, is that it? Nabii, prophet.
Nabii, palme, nabii.
Ho! I had a lady crying. She goes, Nabi from heaven. Oh.
Anasema Nabi kutoka binguni.
I was laughing.
Kwana cheka.
I said, okay.
Sawa.
It's true.
Ikweli.
It's true.
Ikweli.
Somebody lift your hands.
Mtu anyoshe mkono wake.
If you're not walking very aggressively with the Lord,
kama utembei kwa kushikamana na Bwana,
and looking all through yourself,
na ukijitazama na kujichunguza maishani mwako,
examining your life,
na kujichunguza maishani mwako,
you, if you do that,
ukiwa utafanya hivyo,
continuously too much,
ukiendelea kwa kuendelea,
you will fail to become what Jesus has ordained you to be.
Utakosa kufanyika kile ambacho Mungu alikusudia uwe.
And that is to be a revivalist.
Na wewe uwe mtu ambaye anavuvua.
Somebody pray right now with me.
Mtuombe pamoja nami.
Inshallah sekolo sheto. That's the name of this ministry. That's the name of this place. Do you want revival? Do you want revival? Somebody shout. You're too quiet. Come on, somebody shake yourself and shout. From the back, let me hear your voice. Shout right now. Don't sit there like this.
Oh, I'm just listening.
You can't say it's my English. My English is perfect. So you should understand me anyway. You listen to Queen Elizabeth. You listen to King Charles. You can listen to me. I don't speak with a heavy accent. Southern, Northern. I'm very clear. I speak very clearly. God has given me that gift. It's almost like I have no accent. I just speak clear English. Pure English.
Kiingereza safi.
But even if you're not getting that, you're getting our friend here. In your language. So it's a double sword. You can't escape. It's a double-edged sword. Like Hebrews 4:12 said, the word is like a two-edged sword. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say, Lord Jesus, I'm called to be a revivalist.
Sema Bwana nimeitwa kuwa mtu wa uvuvio.
That doesn't just mean preacher. That means you to carry the power of God in your own life.
Come on now.
And then you'll begin to prosper and you'll have God's favor and things will begin to happen. And everybody, including us, will look at you and go, whoa, look at that person. How are they getting so blessed? The first repentance you need to do is for you. The first revival you need to see happen is for you. Not everybody else, for you. I told people, you're crying for Kenya. The Indians have the paper factory. They make all the tissue boxes. And everybody comes to what you call the solemn assembly or whatever it is. And they're like,
boo-hoo.
Oh, bless our nation. And look at you. Look at you. What about you? Forget about the nation. I want to look at you. Lift your hands. I schedule the appointment with you and the Holy Ghost. You're going to sit at the conference table across from God. Amen.
Amen.
And he's going to look at you and say, what are you doing now, my child? I told you this. I showed you this. Are you doing it yet? And you'll be shocked. You'll say, oh my God, Lord, Lord. I'm thinking about everybody else. The Lord says prophetically, you got to think about yourself. First. And then you go to the world. God will not use a man. God will, I'm telling you, God will not use a man or use a woman with great power. Unless they first are clean. Unless they first are Jesus' disciple. Personally. Say amen.
Amen.
Say that's me. I'm going to be his disciple. I'm going to be his revivalist. I'm going to be his blessed son. You women say, I'm going to be his blessed daughter. I started to say in Isaiah 1:18. Come, let us reason together. Let us work out all the issues of my life. Until you allow God to shine the spotlight upon you. And you say like Isaiah, I'm undone. I come from an unclean people. Unless you like Abraham. Who was of Terah's house in the Ur of Chaldees. Genesis chapter 12:1. And they were idol worshippers. And the Bible never says that Terah, his father, was a good man. But the Bible says he went to Abraham and called him out of his father's house. He said, now you begin to walk where I show you. The principle of this, of Abraham, that's applicable to every life, is that you can hear God, put your hands on your ears, lay your hand on your heart, put your other hand on top of your head, on top of your head, and say, Lord, talk to me. And what you say, I'll do it.
Kile
we look at Abraham like he's far away. We look at King David and King Solomon like they're far away. But God had the pages written about them for our example. That we could begin to be like them. I was
on the television broadcast with Bishop.
Nilikuwa katika runinga pamoja na askofu.
And the Lord began to have me explain how all the patriarchs in the Bible were wealthy men.
Mungu akaanza kunisaidia kueleza wale baba zetu wa kiroho bila alikuwa ni watu wenye mali.
They were very, very rich financially.
Walikuwa ni watu wenye mali na pesa.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Why?
Kwa nini?
Kwa nini?
Kwa nini?
Because God, I know. He's telling me how to talk Swahili. Like, I know how to speak. How many minutes? 5 minutes. Thank you, Bishop. Kwa nini? Yeah. That's right. So far away we think they are from us.
Tunafikiria kule mbali sana.
But the next verse in Isaiah 1:19 said, Isaiah
1:19 inasema,
if you are willing and obedient,
ikiwa utatamani na utii.
The prophet Isaiah was instructed to tell us.
Isaia aliambiwa tueleze.
Then you will eat the good of the land.
Kisha mtakula mema ya inchi.
Lift your hands, say, that's for me.
Sema hiyo ni yangu.
You'll eat the good of the land. I touched this microphone. I've not said anything of
tangia
myself.
Niguaguze kipaza sauti cha ongea lolote langu.
The Lord God is speaking through me.
Mungu ananena kupitia kwangu.
We need to understand that.
Lazima tuelewe hilo.
We listen to so many men and we think it's them preaching.
Tunadhania ni wanadamu tu wanaongea.
But I'll tell you something funny.
Acha nikwambie jambo hapa.
Sometimes it is them preaching.
Wakati mwingine ni wao wanahubiri.
Sometimes it is just them preaching.
Ni wao wenyewe wanahubiri.
But the will of God is that the Holy Ghost comes through us and speaks to his people. Lift your hands and say, I receive your words, Lord.
Nalipokea neno lako ewe Bwana.
Now in Isaiah 45, I don't have time to go to the next one. I was going to go to another one, I don't have time. Isaiah 45 and Psalm 45.
Zaburi 45.
And Psalm 61 from verse 3.
Na 61 kuanzia 3.
You can look those up and read those later.
Unaweza kuyasoma baadaye.
But in Psalm 45,
Zaburi 45,
it talks about the palace that the king rules from.
Inasema kuhusu hemaya ambayo rais anatawala.
And I'll leave you with this today. Do you know that we are his royalty?
Ukijua sisi ndio wale wa kuhani.
Yet look at how you're living.
Angalia vile unaishi.
Are you tired of it?
Je, mechoshwa?
Are you tired of the life you have here?
Umechoshwa na maisha mliona hapa?
Until you get tired of it, it won't change.
Hadi uchoshwe na maisha unaishi.
Why? Because you won't change it.
Maana wewe ubadilishi.
And something else.
Jambo lingine.
God won't change it for you.
Mungu hata kubadilishia.
The reason why the heathens even succeed in business and industries and governments.
Sababu ya wale watu ambao hawajaokoka wananawiri kwa biashara na kwa serikali.
Because they make decisions to do what they want to do.
Maana wanaamua kufanya kile wanataka kufanya.
Yet many people in the church are saying, "Oh Lord, if you want."
Kuna wengi ambao wanasema Bwana ukitaka.
God says, "No, I want already."
Mungu anasema tayari nataka.
But you have to want it.
Lakini lazima wewe unitake.
Everybody stand on your feet.
Simama mguuni pako.
If you're a king,
kama wewe ni mfalme,
stand on your feet, everybody stand up please.
Kila mmoja asimame mguuni
mwake. Even the babies, even the adults stand up.
Watoto wadogo wakubwa wote tusimame.
If you're a king,
kama wewe ni mfalme,
why don't you have a palace?
Kwa nini usiwe na hemaya yako?
If you're a queen, why don't you have a palace?
Kama wewe malikia, mbona usiwe na ikulu ama hemaya yako?
Something's very wrong.
Jambo linakosekana mahali.
But when you get in the presence of God.
Lakini ukiingia kwa uwepo wa Mungu.
Someone lift your hands.
Mtu anyoshe mkono wake.
When you get in the presence of the Almighty.
Unapoingia kwa uwepo wa Mungu.
You'll see the prosperity come to you.
Utaona fanaka ikikujia.
And prosperity's definition is this.
Na kuelewa kwa tafsiri ya kufanikiwa ni hili.
Having an abundance of God's supply.
Kujawa na utele wa Mungu.
To do his will.
Kufanya mapenzi yake.
Somebody thought, when God blesses me, I'll do something.
Mtu anafikiria nikibariki Mungu akinibariki nitafanya kitu.
That's wrong, that's backward.
God says, no, you start doing everything I've shown you. Catch this now. Lift your hands. Catch this now. You do everything you can do right now with whatever you have in front of you. And God will see your faithfulness, and then he will begin to add the abundance and the increase. Until you made the decision to do what he wants,
kufanya kile ambacho anataka,
he has no obligation to just give you everything.
Ana haki ya kupea kila kitu.
Are you hearing God's servant?
Je, unasikiza kile nanena?
You have to decide.
Lazima uwe na tamanio.
The Lord spoke to me on Friday in the city.
Bwana alinenea Ijumaa wakati pale mjini.
I was speaking in a great conference with Archbishop Harrison Naga.
Nilikuwa nahubiri kwa kongamano pale.
And the other team from Nigeria.
Na wahubiri wengine.
And the Lord spoke and said this to me in the morning. He said, I want you to have dominion. Lift your hands. And he said, my will is that you have it. And he said, now I turn it all over to you. Just wave your hand to the Lord as I'm going. And say, Lord, I turn myself into your hands.
Baba, najipeana mikononi mwako.
God says, as you do, I turn everything over to
anasema,
you.
Nami mnakupeana yote.
But the weight of the power of the decision is with us.
Lakini nguvu ya mamlaka ya uamuzi iko nasi.
Are you hearing this?
Je, umesikia hili?
It's not just with him.
Sio na yeye.
He already decided to bless us. He already decided to give us every good thing. So what are we waiting for? Lift your hands and pray in the Holy Ghost right now. Just pray right now. As our bishop is coming. By the way, I want to just say honor to them, to him, his wife, Bishop Dr. Ken.
Ninashukuru mke wake pamoja na
Mama Bishop Mercy Ken.
Mercy Ken.
I didn't tell you the middle name. I have to tell you, I forgot.
Sikwambia jina la katikati.
You need to give yourself another name.
Nataka ujipele jina lingine.
You know, in Africa, we say, hello, my names are.
Unajua wa Afrika tunasema majina yangu.
One lady got up to testify. She said, hello, my names are Helen. I said, no, proper English, please. Your name is Helen. But in Africa, you have many names, yes? So my names are. So I'll give you another one. You have to have I don't care inside of me. I don't care what people think. I don't care what other people want. I want what God wants. Come on. I need what he has for me. I don't care about the devil. I don't care about his friends. I don't care about the public opinion. I don't care what people say or people think. It means nothing to me. I don't care. Me, you say in Nairobi, me, I don't care. Me, I am in town. Me, I like this. Me, I'm going. Say this, me, I don't care. Shout me, I don't care. Get the mind of God and the will of God and want what he wants. And nothing else. How many will make that decision today as I'm jumping off the stage? Pray in the Holy Ghost right now. Say, Lord, I decide. Lord, I'm sorry for wasting time. Lord, please forgive me. From today, everything changes for the better in my life. Woo! I'm Thomas Manton the Fourth. I love you. I'll see you again. You find me on thomasmanton.com.
Thomasmanton.com.
That's my website.
You know my afazake?
Thomasmanton.
Thomas.
.com. Thomasmanton.com.
Thomasmanton.com.
You can get my free e-newsletter and books and all the resources and the social media channels. Can we give our beloved Bishop, Dr. Ken Kamau, and his beautiful wife, Dr. Mercy Ken, a mighty hand clap? Come on, give him a. Give God a praise for them. They made this all possible. And for Archbishop who recommended us. God bless you. I love you. Can you blow me a kiss? I need some love right now. Oh, I feel it. Wow. Give me another one. I need another one. Do you love me?
Yes.
Are you glad I came to help you? I love you too. God bless you. Now let's give Jesus one. He's the Alpha and the Omega. He's the beginning and the end. He's the bright of the morning star. He's the soon and coming King. He's the Bishop and Overseer of our souls. He's the everlasting Father, the Amen, the faithful and the true, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The Rose of Sharon, the Lily of the Valley, the Bright of the Morning Star, the Day Spring, the Day Star, the Great Shepherd, the Door of the Sheep. He's our boss. Come on, lift your hands to him and praise him right now.
Amen. Let's celebrate. Let's clap for him. Let's clap for him. He's on fire. He's on fire for God. This place called revival. Piga Yesu makovi. Amen. Thank you so much. Can you stretch both of your hands to the prophet? Tell him, we love you. We appreciate. Thank you for allowing God to use you. Feel welcomed again. Do welcome him again. Do want him again. Hallelujah. Piga makovi na shangwe. Amen. Thank you so much, Prophet of God. We are happy. We value your ministry. We value and we have received what God gave you for us. May God bless you. God give you an opportunity. Welcome again and again. Do you welcome him? And thank you so much. God bless you.
Dear brethren, in Psalms 119:105, the Bible says, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Truly, God has sent Prophet Dr. Thomas Manton IV to proclaim and declare his word of abundance and prosperity prophetically unto the nations. Thus, brothers and sisters in Christ, I urge you, just as the Bible says in Matthew 10:41, whoever welcomes a prophet as a prophet will receive a prophet reward. Let us welcome and embrace the prophet of God by supporting his ministry. You can sow a seed. You can send your love offering. You can support or partner in the ministry program using the details displayed on your screen. For when the prophet of God decrees a blessing upon you, indeed, you shall be blessed.